Align and distribute. For that, we will open a file. Select distribute _01.es from the project file folder on the root of the DVD and the subfolder ES. Zoom out a little. We're going to work with this toolbar. So, to make things more clearly, I will drag it out of the mainframe. If you want to align objects, we have to, of course, first select the objects. You can choose your options from here. And when you've chosen one option, say like center vertical, the apply knob, button, excuse me, becomes available. And if you press it, the command will be applied. The guidelines are here for a reason. I wanted to align these objects on these guidelines. So I press Ctrl-Z or undo. As you can see, this first object is placed exactly between the guidelines. As with many things in EasySign, last selected is a placeholder. So if I select all the objects, press Shift, click once to deselect it, click once to select it. I know this object is the last selected object. Or I do it like this, I select all the other objects, and with Shift key pressed this object. When I now execute the command, I know for sure this object will stay in its place and all the other objects are aligned accordingly to his position. Like so. Directly on the toolbar you can use the distribute or space evenly, whatever you want to call it, options together with the alignment options. So if I want to make all the spaces between the objects the same size, the same width in this case, I select this option and press apply. Now all the spaces between the objects are exactly the same. I will undo this twice. Don't have to use this option, I can also only use this option. Just as well, so I can only use this option. You can combine this row with this row. I first use this option, equalize horizontal distances, but you can also do it equal distances left-left, center-center, or right-right. In this case, nothing will happen, simply because of the fact that all of these objects are exactly the same size. For that, we scroll the page downward. Here we have objects that are all different sizes. So we select these because I want this one to stay in place. I select this one last. First, equalize horizontal distances. Every distance here is equal to the distance or to the other distances. When I choose left, left, from this left position to this left position is the same as this left position from this left position, and so on. Same goes for center, and the same goes for right. If you want objects to occupy a certain space, if you select this one again, of these objects again, then this one last, and equalize horizontal distance and say apply. This one is the placeholder because this one is selected last, so this object will always keep its place. The other objects are aligned according to that, and the complete distance is determined by the most left and most right object, or in case of vertical alignment, the top and bottom object. So if you want a smaller space between it, just put the last, or in this case the right object, farther to the left, or further to the right to give it more space between the objects. If you have a case like this one, or a situation like this one, and I will put this option off, makes it more clearly. Here, the horizontal distances are all the same, but they will overlap because the space between the outer right and the left object, or the first and the last, however you want to call it, is too small, at least for this purpose. Here it goes the same, further to the right, this object last as placeholder. I'm going to use this option as well. Now you have some white space between it, between the objects. Of course, there's even another method for this, and with even greater control than this one. We're first going to select them, red one last. We're going to put this bar back to its place just by simply double clicking on it. And we're going to choose arrange, space evenly, distribute. We're going to do nothing with the vertical alignment for the moment. We want to have the same space between the objects horizontally. And now we can specify the distance. In this case we'll use 20, which is the same width as the objects have. If we press apply, all the objects have the same distance. If we want to align them vertically, we could use center-center. And if we do not use specify distance and press apply, all the vertical distances are made equal to each other. But we wanted to have them on one line. We keep still this option pressed, specify distance, enter 0 and press apply. If you would enter 10 here and press apply, every object is 10 millimeters higher or up vertically accordingly the previous position. We focus ourselves a lot on horizontal alignment, and it's about the same goes for vertical alignment. We will open another worksheet for that. We use distribute 02 from the same folder. We zoom out to the page. Now we want to align all these objects to the outer side of the page and with equal distances according to each other. And I have already drawn some guidelines here to show you where the objects will be placed after the alignment. If you select only one object, group or bitmap, doesn't matter, but only one object, and you use the alignment options, the alignment will take place to the page or the worksheet. So if I say align left and align top and press apply, with one object selected, this object will align to the left and the top of the page. Do the same for the most right object, right, top, apply. This one, right, bottom, apply. And this one, left, bottom, apply. Now we're going to align them to each other. Select top objects. Select this one or this one. But I choose this one as last for placeholder. I'm going to align them vertically. Centered. We could use this or this option because these objects are all the same width and height, but I'll choose this one. And we make the horizontal distances equal. Press apply. This is also a horizontal alignment. So instead of doing this one first and then every time resetting the settings, I'll just select the bottom row, select this object as placeholder and press enter or apply. Then I select these objects and this one last. Center horizontal and make the vertical distances the same. Press apply. This object or this row is the same, or at least the same settings. Apply. Then we can use the same settings for every next row. I forgot one, so I shift click and select it in the same selection. Once deselect, once you select, so this is the last selected, press enter. I keep saying enter, but I mean apply. Apply. And the last one, apply. For the last example and the last options on the toolbar, we're going to open another file. We're going to select distribute_03.es. Open. I'm going to zoom to the page. I'm going to select these objects and say align to the center of the page. This is a group, as you can see in the object manager or in the status bar. So the complete group is aligned to the center of the page. We're going to undo that. We're first going to ungroup them. We're going to select these objects first, this object last. For alignment on the center of the page, this is not necessary, but it is necessary for the options I want to show you a few seconds later. So, center on page is activated, press apply. All the objects are placed on the center of the page. You press undo. If you select this option, every object will be made the same width. And that's why I selected this one last, because this is the biggest. And I want all of these objects to have the same width simultaneously as they are aligned on the center of the page. So I press enter and they all have the same width. If I activate this option now, EasySign still knows this was the last selected object. And if you press apply, all of the objects are the same width and height. I'm going to undo this a few steps. This of course also works with alignment that is not on the center of the page. I just deactivate this option. Red one is still selected last, is still in memory. And now I press apply. The red one stays on its place, and the rest of the objects are aligned in the center of this object, and now all have the same width and height.